Today is the 10th day of the 8th month on the Most High's restored calendar. It is October 14th on Satan's calendar. We are now 19 days into the count from the end of the 1260 days of his witness against the scattered descendants of Israel that leads to the last great day of the great and the fearful day of YEHWEH. In recent videos, the Most High has shown us that his word testifies that these 42 months were not the end of his end time timeline. He did so by revealing the full meaning of the 30 plus 45 days, or the 75 days beyond this time that he gave to us through his servant Daniel in chapter 12. The 1290 and the 1335 days of this prophecy follow the time, times, and a half a time that he gave to us in the previous verses. The revelations of his only begotten Son testify that this time, times, and half a time of this prophecy is referring to the 1260 days of his 42-month witness against the scattered descendants of Israel. Therefore, the 1290 is 30 days past this period of time, and the 1335 is 75 days past it. In lieu of the Most High restoring his 30-day months as part of his witness against you, and in lieu of the emphasis that his word puts upon his 30-day months and the way that they balance through the testimony of his word the way that they do, and in lieu of how there are 42 of these restored 30-day periods that are in his witness against you, and in lieu of what 30 days after this period of time represents with his stamping his judgment upon profaning his appointed times with this 30-day waypoint landing on the last day of Jeroboam's profane feast, and how the Most High has tied this profaning of his appointed times into the same sin that the abomination of desolation brought forth, rebellion to YEHWEH's word, this 1290-day prophecy speaks for itself. But what about the 1335 days? The Most High has shown us how 1335 days flows into the timing that he is going to open my mouth, but why did he choose to use 75 days after his witness against you to do so? There is only one significant reference to 75 that is found in the testimony of his word. It is found in Genesis chapter 12. YEHWEH said to Abram, "Depart from out of your country and from your family and from your father's house to a land that I will show to you." Keep in mind that we are now in the day of the second Exodus, the day that the Most High has bid for you to leave the dead and to flee into his mountains, and even to the place that he has placed his name at this time. Verse 2, "And I will make a great nation of you, and I will bless you, and I will magnify your name, and you will be a blessing. And I will bless them that bless you, and I will curse them that curse you, and you will be blessed among all of the families of the earth." So Abram walked, or he journeyed, and he did that which YEHWEH spoke to him, and Lot walked with him. Abram was 75 years old when he left Haran. But almost none of you have done that which he has spoken for you to do at this time. He has spoken for you to flee from touching the dead and to turn back to him through that which he has restored. He has spoken for you to flee into his mountains at this time. He has spoken for you to stand with his two anointed sons, his two witnesses. Do you think that this 75-year parallel is a coincidence to the 1335-day, the 75 days of the 1335-day prophecy found in chapter 12 of his servant Daniel's prophecy? Well, we will soon find out. We are now only 11 days from the 1290-day waypoint of this prophecy and 56 days from this 1335-day waypoint. The timing of this video is indeed significant. The Most High has woven volumes of 11-day parallels into his timeline in order to magnify his signet ring that he has placed upon my hand. And the last period of time that is recorded in his timeline of the events of the flood is the 56 days from when he told his servant Noah to remove the covering from the ark until he opened the door for his servant and his family to come off of it 56 days later. The point of these parallels is not that today is 11 days and 56 days from a random date. The point is they are simultaneous parallels from the beginning of a 1260-day period of time that the Most High established at minimum over 3,000 years ago. Anyway, these parallels are small in significance to the significance of the 75-year parallel of which Yahweh called his servant Abram out from Haran when he was 75 years old. If you think that the 1,335-day prophecy being 75 days after the 1,260-day prophecy is a coincidence, this is certainly your choice to do so. Prepare to be humbled. Yahweh told his servant Abram, who he later gave the name Abraham to, that he would bless him if he would leave his land for his kingdom's sake, in obedience to his word. Concerning the 1,335-day waypoint, his word tells us in Daniel chapter 12, verse 12, blessed is he that waits and conquers to 1,335 days. You would have to be pretty stiff-necked to think that this 75-day span is a coincidence. If it is, then this 75-day span is merely a random span in time with no known meaning to it, since there are no other direct references to 75 days or 75 years found in the testimony of Yahweh Elohim's word. Such random things do not exist in the testimony of his word. Turn back. The great and the fearful day of his wrath is at hand.